Hey, everybody, it's the coach. You're tuned in to Sunday Night Football on EA Sports. Coming up, we've got a good one on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the Oakland Raiders. So with that, let's get out to the East Bay and Oakland, California. On the call, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Oakland, California. The pregame festivities here in Oakland have to be seen to be believed. This crowd in silver and black, they are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Dallas Cowboys. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis, thrilled to be with you from the broadcast booth. And partner, before we get this thing started, what are you going to be watching?
Who gets off to a fast start? In horse racing terms, they talk about catching a flyer out of the gate. Who sets the pace and makes the other team chase?
To two of the more fervent fan bases around, the Cowboys and the Raiders are underway. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So here comes the Raiders offense now onto the field. They're led out by their quarterback out of Fresno State, Derek Carr.
The thing I like most about Derek Carr's game is not just the right arm and his touch and his ability to find receivers. I think it's his calmness, and I think that transmits itself very well to the rest of the team. They feed off of that, and they go out and play with confidence.
Down. Here's a short little toss to Carrier. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. A look now at the Oakland offense.
In the NFL, we love to talk about bloodlines and how important they can be. And for Zay Jones, he's got a terrific one. His dad, Robert, longtime linebacker in the NFL, big time with the Dallas Cowboys. And his uncle, Jeff Blake, a starting quarterback in the NFL at one point. Wonder if he played catch with Uncle Jeff in the backyard a few times growing up.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Here's Carr. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And now the defense for Dallas.
Robert Quinn gets to the quarterback as well as any defensive end in the league. A lot of it goes back to his high school wrestling background. He understands leverage and hands as well as anyone.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and 9.
That's gonna be a long day.
Shotgun now for Carr. Got a man, it's complete. Williams. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Give him a first down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Come on, baby. I'm coming, baby.
First carry for Josh Jacobs. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. On second down, Jacobs. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
That one, a first down pickup of 8. The one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Carr defers to Jacobs on the draw. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
On 2nd and 9, Carr got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 34-yard line. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. This pass from Carr taken in by Waller. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a gain in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that'll open things up for you on the outside as well.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it. All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the 2nd and 3rd level.
That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's 2nd and 13. He's going to find and complete it to Renfro. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Right off the bat, they start with a very solid, methodical 10-play drive.
And you know me, I tend to look at things from the defensive side. They're coming off the field gassed right away. We're in the first drive of the game. So it's not just what happened, but think of the emotion you carry into a game, then double it with getting a 10-play drive put on you and points scored. They're pretty tired right now.
Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. And that makes it 7-0 Oakland. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it ends with an Oakland touchdown. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Cowboys under head coach Jason Garrett as they get set for their first opportunity. As we get a peek at their dynamic signal caller hailing from Mississippi State, it's Dak Prescott. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. And on this offensive unit, your thoughts on Travis Frederick?
He's a quarterback's best friend. Sets all the line calls and blocks so aggressively.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Here's Elliott. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30. And we take a look now at the defense for the Raiders.
Let's talk about Vontez Burfict, the versatile linebacker. You can play him inside, you can play him outside. Undrafted coming out of college, and that still fuels him. Gives him that huge chip on his shoulder. And when he's right and plays at his best, one of the best linebackers in the league. Just has to know where the line is so he doesn't go past it and cost his team some penalties.
And the Raiders call on a nickel set for 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
So on 4th down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Back deep for the Raiders, Jalen Richard. The Raiders swarm in and block it. It's picked up. Remember, the ball is live. And the Raiders are in for 6. Touchdown. In for the score. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage.
As you well know, every block punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens, and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
Carlson on for the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. Able to get the pressure, get a paw on it, knock it down, and then go and grab it and take it into the end zone. What a play. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now, heading back out onto the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And now it looks like we've got a Cowboy shaking up down there on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Oakland after this.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. When you're down early, how do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Quick throw, and it's caught by Gallup. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you. Switch. Switch. 26.
On second down, it's Pollard. Runs through the contact. And some room to maneuver. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's got the connection to Cooper. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And it's caught. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately because if you let that big guy get ahead of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
In your face.
Now Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble. And now it's 3rd down. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes 3rd and goal. To throw is Prescott. Out to his left. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. Taking it in from a yard out as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns 3rd and goal into a touchdown. Kai Forbath on for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. To throw, it's Carr. And a big loss here as he's taken down. DeMarcus Lawrence. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down.
Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. Working from the gun, it's Carr. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down. But prior to that, he had hit his first six passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game, you know, because you do practice it, you do go through it, and in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it up.
On second down now, it's Jacobs. This will go for five up to the 33.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
It's a gain of five. Brings up third.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. From the gun, it's Carr. Able to find Waller. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down.
When the offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. To throw his car. They'll find his tight end. That's Waller. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Carr gives to Richard. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. A 6-yard pickup on the ground that time, and that'll make it third and 4 coming up.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Watch the car! Watch
from the gun now on third down. Carr, he's got his man. It's Williams. And he's got the first, but we also have a flag on the field.
Offense.
And they're already walking backwards. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. Operating from the gun. Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 33.
They looked his way quite a bit, and in my estimation, as well they should.
Well, that's now five catches in this first half alone.
And he picks up another first down. He's been an important part of their offense here early.
Over 100 yards passing in just this first quarter. It's first and 10. From the gun, Carr. The open man here, Renfro. And he'll go down at the 28. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
First down, they go with Jacobs again. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Jalen Smith, the Notre Dame man, in on the tackle.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. To the outside, that's complete to Williams. And they'll lose yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And that's going to make it third down and 10. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. The Raiders on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 10. Operating from the gun. Carr. That is caught at the 7. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They come out here in the eye. So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Carr. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
When you get your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
It's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. They'll run it with Jacobs. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That second down play nets a minus four.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Now Carr, and that is incomplete.
And I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
Fourth down, and on comes the Raider kicker, Daniel Carlson. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Carlson able to put this one through. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. That drive just seemed to go for an eternity. I could kind of hear our sponsor saying, hey, we need to get our product pushed here. But then it ends in a field goal.
Yeah, how about that? Not enough time for product placement, but plenty of time to get 3 points out of the deal. I know that the guys on defense, though, they wanted to get those products out there. They wanted to stop that drive, just weren't able to do so.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And this is one of those plays that if you can use it to keep the chains moving, it's a good play. And not only that, it tends to tamp down the pass rushers because they have to recognize this play and stay at home. The quarterback uses it well. Read option, keeps it, and picks up a first down with some nice running.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll run with Elliott, and this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Well, he can be a load to handle off the edge, and he can do it against the pass. Sure, he can do it against the run like he did there.
And you mentioned a load. How about having to adjust to his speed as well? Because not only does he bring some pop, he brings some dash as well. A nice play in that situation.
Second down, Elliott. He'll get three up to midfield.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play? A dime look defensively for the Raiders on third down.
Yeah, you're right. Two extra DBs out there. Prescott now from the 50. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. And remember, he had his first punt blocked. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. Derek Carr getting set and ready to go again on offense here. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of it. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now Carr. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 12 yards that time and an Oakland first down. Carr now, 13 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10. From the gun, Carr. And Waller taking it in over the middle. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Running is Jacobs. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Here's Carr to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, and it's third down. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
The Raiders on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and four. Operating from the gun. Carr. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This will be kicked from the 42. It's a 52-yard attempt. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field and down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Good field position to start the drive after the missed field goal. Here's first down from the 42. Elliott. And he'll take this for about four up to the 46-yard line.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
To throw on second and six, Prescott. He finds Randall Cobb with a completion. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Give him 18 on that one, and it's a Dallas first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Hey, pick it up, defense.
Prescott from the gun. He's going to find Gallup here complete. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. And now he'll tuck it and run. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
To throw again on second down. Prescott, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Benson Mayoa able to drop him for a loss of a couple.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Here's Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Looking to throw. Prescott. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. It was Darrell Worley there to knock that one free.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Throwing, Prescott. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Prescott on third and goal. He may try and run for this. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
On now is Kai Forbath to try the field goal. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. And Forbath will put this one through, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. So it's an old-school extra point that counts three times. So it's certainly a disappointment they weren't able to get it in the end zone.
Yeah, I can just imagine post-game, head coach looking at the box score, 19-yard field goal, grimacing a little bit, but having to realize that at that moment, getting 3 points was vital. Go ahead and get the points, put them on the board.
Forbath now to kick it away after the made field goal. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Derek Carr and the Raiders set for their next possession. They've got the lead. He's a big reason why. Looking sharp so far.
And as we travel around the league, we see quarterbacks get it done in a variety of ways. But today's NFL does tell us one thing. If that guy doesn't play well, their team's not going to win. And right now, he's got his team in the lead.
And now they'll look to extend that lead. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Carr now to throw. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. To throw again. Carr. Jones has it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one good for 26 and a first down.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play on the football.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now Carr. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. They run it with Jacobs. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times, and what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle end up making the play.
The Raiders on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 7. Throwing now is Carr. He'll find his running back. It's Jalen Richard. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 35.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
Here's Jacobs on 1st and 10. And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc, because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
On 2nd down, Richard. And he's got this pretty close to a 1st down at the Cowboys 26.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. To throw, it's Carr. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. So much for the run on third and one. Instead, it's a big chunk in the pass game. First down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Jacobs, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the six. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Second and goal from the six this time. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. On the draw, Richard. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop. Ball right around the five here brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. On fourth down, here's Daniel Carlson for the Raider field goal. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. The kick by Carlson is good. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to three.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Amari Cooper and the rest of the offense heading back out there now. They've got to find a way to get him more involved in this game plan. Down here in the second quarter, he doesn't even have a catch.
And don't think they're not hearing about it in the huddle and on the sidelines. And we often think of wide receivers at times being disruptive. It's just that they know their talents and they know the type of plays they can make, and they can make big ones. They want the ball to help their team.
Now you got
to
think he's going to want the ball more. One target, no catches. A first down throw for Prescott. But he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And able to to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 17 yards on the play there, and the Cowboys have a first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Just under a minute to play in half number one.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll throw again. Prescott. He's got his target. It's Cobb. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To the air again, Prescott. Completes it to Jason Witten. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Here's a four receiver look now. Three of those guys out to the right side on second and 8. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He's going to look end zone here for Cooper. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, 38 yards. As they are now just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for, and this touchdown will count. Now Forbath for the extra point. It's up and good, and the lead's now down to 3 at 20-17. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Horvath to send it away now following the touchdown. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And now Oakland ready to take the field.
You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you've got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
Down. He'll find his running back here, Richard. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Here's Carr. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three.
Check, check.
Working from the gun, it's Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. On fourth down, A.J. Cole comes on to punt. Back deep for the Cowboys, Tavon Austin. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Now Dak Prescott of the offense heading back onto the field. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but they're losing. And I think as the captain of the offense, you probably always feel like you need to do more in that situation.
The best have always felt that way. And they won't settle for anything less. So right now, his goal is to increase what he's doing on the field, try to make sure his teammates come along with him, and he feels like if I do better, everyone will do better. And that's what we're seeing from him right now. Got to have a little extra determination.
Yeah, a little extra determination. He has thrown the touchdown pass, no interceptions for him personally to this point.
The first down run for Elliott will net him about 5 yards. It's second down. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play of half number one. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been as good as advertised, just a field goal separating these two teams as they've already made their way back out of the locker room. So to bring you the story of the second half, let's get you right back out to Brandon Godden.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk
when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, and that'll bring up second down.
Certainly looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Prescott now. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The product of Jersey City, Tahir Whitehead on the sack. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. It appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
And he puts a little something extra into this one, by far his best of the night. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we've got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. He completes it to Jones. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Now those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there. Second down now. It's Jacobs. And for a second straight play, that Cowboy defense gets him to the ground behind the line of scrimmage.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. Here's Carr to throw.
It's caught. Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That'll put him at 66 receiving yards now for the game, and he's got a first down. Tight end, that's Waller. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Here we go, D. Here I'm coming.
Jacobs now. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Here's A.J. Cole now as he'll kick it away for the second time. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot him. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Now Elliott. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Tenth carry now for Elliott. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Complete to Jason Witten. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Dak fighting his tight end. Witten and the Cowboys have a first down. Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 43. Prescott to throw it. And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43.
He's not going anywhere.
And again, it's Prescott. Trying for Cooper again. This time he finds it. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school.
A first down carry by Elliott. Oh, nice move. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Play action now. Prescott. That one complete. Elliott. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it 1st and goal.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. Down at the 2. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at 2nd and goal.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Good yardage on 1st down. Now can they punch it in on 2nd and goal? They'll try to run it in with Elliott, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that is going to set up 3rd and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
One receiver to the left is Cooper. From back at the 3 now, this is 3rd and goal. Prescott from the gun. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. Max Crosby in there to get him for a loss of 3, and it will be 4th down.
You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
And for the 2nd time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Forbath will put this one through, and that's going to tie things at 20. So a good snap, good hold, and right down the middle.
Never in doubt, just the way you used to hit them, partner.
You mean like kicking the ball?
Exactly.
Well, that was in high school.
Doesn't matter. I don't care what level you hit them, they go through.
Fitting for what's been a tight ball game. We're all even at 20 now as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Derek Carr getting ready to go again on offense. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
And throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 22.
I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end can be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to account for him.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10.
All day, every day, any day.
Carr gonna throw. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. Throwing again. Carr, he's going to find and complete it to Renfrow. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 40.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Carr now 6-for-6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Carr to throw again. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Zay Jones was the intended receiver, but it'll be second down. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now a give to Jacobs running right. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
Check 55, Mike. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve we saw right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
Carr now nearing the 300-yard mark with still a quarter to play. It's first and 10. Now a carry for Jacobs. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
From the 22, Carr, and he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags, and I believe this is going to be a first down. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
And they've got another first and 10 as the penalty keeps this drive moving. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. He went backwards 7 yards, setting up a tough third down.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
On third and long, it's Carr. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Daniel Carlson set for the Raider field goal. On the left hash mark, this is a 38-yard attempt. The kick by Carlson is good. And that will break our tie and give him a 3-point lead. It's his third field goal now in the ball game, and they needed his leg. This last one gives him the lead.
It's been a back-and-forth kind of a game, hasn't it? Now you got to tell your defense, guys, we need you to make this stand up because we got the momentum going in the right direction, but we need you to make sure we carry it home.
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super tough.
They'll run on first down. It's Elliott looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. Officially no gain on the play and it's second down.
I think what we just saw their partner was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
Throwing on second down, Prescott. He's got the connection to Cooper. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route, and they just executed that one pretty well.
Prescott now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. To throw is Prescott, letting one fly deep for Cooper. And this is taken in at the 5. It's a big play for the Cowboys on third. 55 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
They come out here in the eye. Now Elliott. So he got three at one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him three on the game there. Second and goal. Here on a Sunday night, and that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Charles, he's able to dive in there in a short yardage situation.
Just find a place to get to the end zone. Didn't matter where it was, but once he did, used his nose for the end zone and dove in.
Forbath to add the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. Five plays there on that drive, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. To send it away now following the touchdown. This will be fielded at the 8. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Carr and the Raiders come up 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Shotgun now for Carr. This will be caught. Tyrell Williams. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him a 1st down, 15 yards that time for the Raiders. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Carr. His throw incomplete. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up 2nd and 10. To throw again, Carr. He rifles one that's intercepted. Xavier Woods with a pick.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Amari Cooper and the Cowboys set to take over once again.
Seems like the measuring stick for a receiver for a great game is 100 yards. Well, he's well past that now.
And as we analyze how he's getting them, that's where it really becomes fun because, let's face it, they keep sending coverage at him, keep trying to put the pressure on, yet he finds ways downfield and finds openings. That's a really crafty receiver.
50.
Another carry tonight for the workhorse, Elliott. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Open man, the tight end Jarwin, and he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. A gain of 6 there on first.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. This to Jarwin. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football.
They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early. Presented himself, no reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Now Forbath for the extra point. And that one pushes the lead up to 11. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. To send it away now following the touchdown. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Derek Carr getting set and ready to go again on offense here.
With his guys trailing here in the fourth, he can ill afford a repeat of the interception that ended the last drive.
Yeah, you're two scores down. You take it upon yourself now to play perfect or near perfect football if you want to get your team back into the game. But it's also tough to do when you're trying to avoid errors, yet still play perfect football.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Going for the deep ball. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. 36 yards on the play.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route well run, and the football right on the money.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. Rashard. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Throwing on second and 14. Carr, that's complete to his tight end, Waller. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6 foot, 6 inch target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6 target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Working from the gun. It's Carr. And this is going to be incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
So out comes the field goal team once more. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a through an opening, and there he goes. The 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. As his guys are in for six, and the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Forbath to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Thank you.
Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field.
Last time they had a little bit of a special teams breakdown. That field goal was blocked.
Yeah, and everything has to be precise in the kicking game. Snap, hold, kick. Obviously the blocking to keep people out. So what you really want to do is get in there and get 6 points and take the pressure off of those guys.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the gun, Carr, Waller taking it in over the middle. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Carr, and he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the 1st down. And that's what he just did.
And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Carr, the open man here, Renfrow. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
Carl come up here with a 1st and 10. And he's hit on all 5 of his pass attempts on this drive so far. Carr completes it. 7 yards the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
Again, they'll throw with Carr. It's a screen to Richard. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And he's going to have another 1st down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 29-yard line. He's having a big game through the air, and sometimes those smart decisions just dump it off. That's how you continue to have big games through the air.
I agree totally. That's a great analogy, a great way to put it, because he doesn't get too greedy where everything has to be pushed downfield, trying to create big plays that aren't there. You dump it off and take that nice gain, and things add up, and now you have the kind of game he's having.
To throw, it's Carr. Darren Waller, the intended receiver. That'll bring up 2nd down. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 17-yard line. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. Into the red zone, it's Carr. That's going to be caught by Williams for a Raiders touchdown. Tyrell Williams there to make the grab. And the Raiders make some inroads here on that deficit. Carlson now to add the extra point. And that one makes this an 11-point deficit now. A 10-play drive that time. And it winds up in 6 points for the Raiders. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
So Prescott to the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 24. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. It's caught, Cooper. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already.
Hey, pick your game up.
26. Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Carl Joseph came roaring in on the safety blitz.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Only two there on the dump off. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The Cowboys on third down. Not quite 50%. 4 for 9. This is 3rd and 16. Prescott from the gun. And that will be incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And now here come the Raiders. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Carr now on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet.
Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up 2nd and 10. Throwing again. Carr. He'll find his running back here, Richard. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up 3rd down.
That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, not able to find any yardage on that one.
The last completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on 3rd down. Operating from the gun, Carr looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
The Raiders do snap it. It's Carr. He's got his man. It's Williams. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on 4th down.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Again, it's Carr. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's 2nd down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a 1-possession game.
Yes.
Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9.
Now, Carr again. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out.
Now!
The last completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on third down. Carr to throw again. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Now, the offense not going anywhere. They're staying out there. They've converted once already on this drive. Here they go again on fourth down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Here's Carr to throw. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfrow. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. First down now, but that clock rolling.
55.
Carr now on first down. That's complete to Rashard, the running back.
Here we go.
It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it'll be second down. The Raiders try to move quickly, try to get everybody back to the line. To throw again on second down, Carr. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. From the gun, it's Carr. And that's knocked away and incomplete. The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith, able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. This will be from 56 yards out. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. And it's hard to hold a kick from this distance against him, but that is now three misses for him in the game so far.
Three! And you wonder where his head's at right now. Kickers are a funny breed, but I have a feeling he'd love to see a 29-yarder next time to get him back in the groove.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. They'll start the drive with Elliott. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8. They go to Elliott again. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth.
Here we go.
third and short yardage. Prescott. And that's Elliott complete. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. Prescott, he goes down to a knee, and that should just about do it. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say good night from Oakland.